Hello there. My name is Valerie White Williams, and I am a voice teacher and a vocal coach for Vocal Splendor Studios. I teach online voice and piano all over the world using Zoom, FaceTime, and Skype. So if you're interested in getting some lessons, please go to my website at vocalsplendor.com. And now you can interact with me in three new ways. I have a Patreon, which definitely helps support me when I make all these reaction videos. And you can find that in the description. I also have, and I'm on Weezio, which is a website which you can create and upload audio and video files of your performance, and I can give you a reaction just like I do here. And number three, I have a free Facebook group, which is called Creative Soul Alignment. And in that, we have all these great creative people that we talk and share information and the arts, about the creative arts and spirituality. So I'd love to see you there, and you can find all the links in the description. And as for today, I'm doing another reaction video. I've had so many people request that I do more Michael Jackson. So today I am reacting to Michael Jackson performing Man in the Mirror in the 1988 Grammys. Let's have a listen. I'm just gonna pause right now. It seemed to me that as he walked up on that stage, there was just a bit of nerves. And a lot of my posters on my comments go, oh, these people are professional, they never get nervous. It's not true. Even people that have been performing for years and years can sometimes have a bit of nerves. And to be honest, it's so much easier to perform in front of a crowd of people that came to watch you than your peers. So performing at the Grammys is really high pressure because all these artists that are amazing are watching you, and it's a little nervy. I've been there, and I'm sure Michael is. So when he walked out, I could tell he's like, okay, here I go. Now, that's not gonna stop them, because a lot of people that are beginning singers, when they feel that rush of energy, they think there's something wrong. It's that fight or flight, and then they just like, oh, I can't do it. But when you're a performer and that's what you do, you know that you just have to push through. And so as he's getting into the singing right now, the more the song goes on, the more he's relaxing and just losing himself in the song. And that's what's so beautiful about Michael. Stop again, because when you see Michael dance and sing, his body is almost like a drummer. So he has all these different limbs going on all at the same times, and it seems somewhat chaotic and crazy, but he's totally choreographed it. And all the time, one of his foot is moving, he's feeling the rhythm in his body. His whole body is his instrument, and his passion, it's every cell and every limb is focused on this storytelling that he's doing.
Oh,
Song builds and builds and builds, and we had, of course, the backup singers that were coming out and doing a little bit of supporting the sound, and now we have the huge choir that's coming out. The song is so amazing, and this is one of the things we love about Michael, is that he has such a big heart. He really cared about humanity, and he's so animated. So let me just talk about, even though his hands are moving and he's got spins, but you watch his mouth. And his mouth is pretty steady. He's not bobbing his head like a lot of singers would do. And he's using that, I'm making the man in the middle. So the jaw, this part of his head stays really stable. And even if he's bending down or bending low, again, he has a lot of that, the head, neck, chin, chest togetherness. And he keeps this part really stable, even though he's moving his body around. And it has that really loose jaw. Yeah. Okay. Talk about those who's. Now look at his mouth, super relaxed jaw. And so when he goes, ha, ha, so he's really using his breath. Notice you're not seeing a lot of tension in this. It's the energy, energy. He's totally energy. And because he was singing for so long as a child, that breath, bringing the energy from his lower breath and really anchoring his body, gives him that power, so he doesn't have to take it from tense necks and things like that. There you could see his body was moving, make that change, and his head is super solid. So again, a lot of people would be wiggling their head around and it's going to compromise the sound. So when he does the wiggling with his head, usually he's not singing and he wiggles the head and then he straight on keeps this alignment. Yeah. the best part was the end where they were actually riffing out with the background singers. It was really interesting because, you know, at the end, like, he was like, when they cut out the band and it was just the background singers and the choir, the a cappella parts, meaning there's no accompaniment, that was my favorite part because they're starting to do this, what we call and response. So call and response comes from really the jazz experience, which comes from the gospel experience, which comes from Africa. So the gospel choir was emerging of the African culture, and the call and response is where you have this riff, man in the mirror, man in the mirror. So you have this continuous riff and then you're singing around it. So the ad lib, as we call it, or the improv or the improvisation. And what was so cool about this is when Michael started kind of going off on his go and just kind of making stuff up and the moment with his great dance moves and the emotion. And then the background singers were starting to echo him. And that's what a lot of jazz singers do, or jazz instrumentalists do, is when jazz players play, they don't play the same way twice. And they play through the head, as we call it, the melody. And then they start kind of playing off each other. And that's what was so cool about that particular moment, when the backup singers were playing off of the riffs that he was doing. And like I said, he would sing and then he would do this and then he would put his head there, and they were playing off each other. Now there was one part where he was laying down, he fell to his knees, and it was almost like that one guy was wondering if he was okay. I don't know if that was really what he thought, or is maybe part of the staging, and he walked right over to him like, are you okay? Got up, and then the energy just continued to increase as he was just like, white men need to do this, the black man needs to do this. And that's another thing about Michael's, he loved everybody. He loved everybody. We all have the responsibility to make this a better world. No one is not going to have to do anything. We all have to do it. And that's the beauty of Michael and his soul and his spirit, that even he sang such a beautiful song. Can you imagine any song like this in the radio today? Yeah, that would probably be a no. Because that kind of music isn't being produced like this. That's inspirational as much. Now, there might be some, but it's mostly about, hey, I can drink and I can party and I can wear sexy clothes. But not this, we can make this world a better place. And I think that is why Michael's legacy is only getting bigger. And I've gotten so many people telling me, more Michael, more Michael, more Michael. And people have even said they think Michael is an angelic being that is here helping us on the other side. Just, that's what I've heard. And there's a movement about that. And you can check that on the internet. So it's very interesting because Michael wanted to make this world a better place. And he didn't just sing about it. He lived it. He traveled all over the world helping a lot of poor people without any attention, without the media following him, not taking pictures. He really cared about people and he liked uplifting people, which is amazing because he had a really rough life as a child. Yeah, it wasn't, he became a star, but he really didn't have a childhood. He grew up in bars and had a father who was very strict. So he had his mission of trying to make the world a better place, and it's real. You can see it. So that's his heart. And then, of course, his dancing is just incredibly amazing. And how he coordinates dancing and singing, he's a masterclass to watch. So all these other artists that actually dance and sing can study him and the way he uses his body when he's not singing, and then holding it upright so he gets that great sound. And again, the loose jaw. But my heart just skipped a beat when I heard the improv with that a cappella section with the choir and the backing sound singers. It was just so magical and so amazing. Walked out there's kind of like a little shy, and then boom, he tore it up, and it was so great. And I'm so happy to see that performance. That's why I like live performances, because everyone is different. There's never going to be the same from the same artist. Everything is different in the moment, especially when we have that sort of interplay with the call and response and just that ad lib that happens. Magic can happen. What a beautiful night. And we got to see it. Thank you for YouTube. All right, if you want more Michael, let me know what other videos I should react to. Make sure you subscribe and click on the bell because I love Michael too. And thank you for the likes, shares, and subscribes. I so appreciate it. So I hope you all have a great day. Bye.